You know what I hate about travel photography is all the other tourists. Okay, I'm kidding. I would love that other people are out there seeing things as well, but I do hate when they get in my photos. I like having a nice clean photo. And so today I'll show you how to clear unwanted people and objects out of your photographs. I think that this is an excellent lens. Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. My name is Emma and professionally I am a software developer, but in my free time I love landscape photography and making related videos here on YouTube. In today's video I'm going to show you how you can remove objects, people, different things from your photographs when there's just stuff in there that you aren't able to get out of the shot in the camera but you actually need to remove afterwards. Now, I will be doing this in Affinity Photo, as is my tendency for my editing videos because that is my favorite photo editing software. However, as always, you will be able to find similar tools in different photo editors. So if you're using Photoshop or something else, you can do these types of things over there as well. So for the first technique that I'm going to show you, I'm just going to show you how you can remove different objects from the photos. These are going to be usually for things that are staying still in the photograph, but that you just didn't want there. And so I'm going to look at this scene of the ocean. I showed you this photo last week. This is without my color edits really applied to it. And the problem here is down in the lower left corner, there are a whole bunch of branches that I just really didn't want in the photo. However, there was no way to get this photograph without those branches being there. They were actually further down on the cliffside. There wasn't a way to move left and right in order to eliminate those branches being there. But they're, you know, I couldn't like break them off or anything. They were well out of reach to push them to the side. I think it was like some grasses or something. But you know, they were some distance away from me. So I need to get rid of them now in my photo editor. The way that I'm going to do that, first of all, is I'm going to use Affinity Photo's Inpainting brush. And what this does is it basically just kind of automatically generates some new filler for whatever area you brush over. So you can actually see I already did this and this was the final result, but now I'll show you how to do it. So the way that I do this, first of all, is I always do these kinds of edits on a new layer just in case I want to get rid of them later, if I want to hide and show them to see how they look or erase anything, make changes. Just easiest to have them on their own layer. So I'll just add a new pixel layer, select the Inpainting brush from my tools on the left hand side, and then make sure that you set the brush to current layer and layer below. So it's using the content from the layer below this in order to fill in where we're removing the objects. And then also set the hardness to zero or something very low, so that you have a really soft brush that you're painting in with, and that'll help everything to blend together more smoothly, not give you any harsh edges between your fill and your layer below. And what I'll do now is just paint over all these branches. Once I do that, let it process for a second, and it's gonna fill it in. Now, it might not get it perfectly the first time, so I will go back and readjust things as needed. Okay, so at this point, I've gotten rid of most of those, but I've left this one here. And the reason is because I've already done this a couple of times now, actually. This branch right here, the Inpainting brush, can't actually quite get rid of properly because of the wave below it. So if I inpaint that, just give it a second to do it. Now we've lost all of the texture in the wave there. And if I, you know, if I kind of do it different ways, you just can't quite get it to fill in and look really perfect the way that you would want it to for a really nice photo. So this right here is probably about the best that I'm gonna be able to get with the Inpainting brush, and it's really just not acceptable. So what I'm going to do now is actually use the clone stamper instead rather than Inpainting, and go over it with that to actually copy other portions of the image over and brush them on. So for that, I will add a new layer again. And select the clone stamp or clone brush tool from the tray over here on the left. And what this lets me do is hold down the option key, select a place for the source, and then brush from where that little plus sign is for the source, brush from that onto wherever the circle is where I am brushing. Again, set the hardness on this to something very low or zero. Select a source, so I'm just gonna fill in some of the sand here again. And you can see it's just gonna brush that back in. And so I can just kind of select some different areas, brush on some of the sand texture. Down here, I can select some of the wave and copy across some of the wave texture onto where those branches were painted out, because that really got lost there. Okay, and so now we've gotten everything except for the front edge of the wave. Now for that, I'm just gonna select along the edge right here. I'm gonna copy that across, but what I can do is actually use the arrow keys to rotate the brush as well so that I can change the angle. And then I'll just kind of be a little bit more careful with it to match up the flow of the waves here to make it look kind of natural as I can get it. Okay, so here now I think is a fairly good adjustment of this. We've gotten rid of the grasses, and we've brought back some of the texture and the definition in the wave using that clone stamper where the Inpainting brush wasn't able to get rid of that. And since I had two layers here, what I would do if I'm doing a big edit is I would push Command G and that will just group them together. And now I can turn them off and see what the wave looked like before, turn them back on and see what it looked like now. Now I probably could have, if I spent a little more time on this, gotten the definition in the wave a little bit better. But I think it's pretty good, especially for a quick edit. If you saw this, you probably wouldn't really realize that those branches used to be there in the photo, and it makes the photo much cleaner. It gives us a nice focused look to be able to see the wave coming in. Now, for the second technique that I want to look at, this one is better really for when there's moving items in the frame, such as people. So if you're in a really touristy spot, there's usually going to be lots of other people there walking, doing their own thing. And it can be really nice to get a clean photograph of that scene without all of the people in it, to have a nice shot of the landscape or whatever. However, you might stand there for hours and never see a time when there's nobody else in the scene. And so with this technique, you can relatively easily get rid of masses of people just by stacking up photos that you took over a period of time. And so I'm just gonna show you how to do that real quick, and then I'll explain as well some of the kind of pitfalls and things that you need to know when you're shooting to make this technique work. So for this, we're gonna look at three photos that I took on this stretch of beach. Now, these are the JPEGs from the camera. I've not put the color edits or any kind of edits on these just because I want to show you the stacking technique. But here's my first shot, second shot, third shot. And you can see that over here in this corner, there's this gentleman in a white t-shirt walking down the beach. He's out enjoying the beach, and that's great. You know, we want other people to enjoy the beach. But this was a fairly popular stretch of beach. There wasn't going to be a time really when nobody was walking in this whole big area. But because he's moving throughout the photo, what I can do is I can stack these three images up, and then because he was in spot A, but then he moved to spot B and moved to spot C, he's not in all three images. And so as a result, when I stack them up, he won't appear in the stack anymore, if that makes sense. So to do that in Affinity Photo, I'll just go to File and to New Stack. Click on Add and select all of the images that I want to use. So I'm gonna use three here because I took three. Now in this case, I probably don't need to use all three because really just from the first one and the last one, there's probably everything that I need there. But I'm gonna go ahead and use all three. If you had more people in more positions, you would obviously want to use more images. And then we're going to select to automatically align the images. That's just gonna make sure that they're lined up for us. Click OK, give Affinity Photo a second to process that. All right, and so now we have our final image right here, and you can see that the person walking down the beach is no longer present in the image because he did not appear in all of those images. Now you can see there's a little bit of kind of ghosting right here, so we could actually just clean that up again with the Inpainting tool just to make it look a little bit better. Just take kind of a small brush here and we can fix that real quick. And there we go. So that, you know, removes that little bit of ghosting that was left as well, and we have a clean looking image with no one else here on the beach. Now, we did maybe lose a little bit of definition in the waves because they were also moving when we did this, but what we could actually do is just add a mask on. So all three of our photos are still here in this live stack group. We could add a mask on, say, the top one right here and just take a black brush. And this is a little harsh, but if I just brushed across there with this solid black brush, you can see how that would add the definition back into the waves there. If we wanted to do that, we could just select the waves even from only one layer. Now, of course, you could stack your images up manually, but that doesn't give you that auto alignment feature. And what Affinity Photo also is giving me here is the ability to select different options for the stacking. So it's on the median mode right now. That's the default mode, and that's the one that's gonna remove objects. But I could select mean, outlier, maximum, minimum, etc. down through here. There's lots of different stacking options that you might want to use in different situations. So for example, the mean mode, that's of course taking an average mathematically of the pixels in the image. And with that one, you can see if I zoom in with the mean, you can see kind of the trails of this person walking across the beach. Maybe at some point that might be something that you would want to do. Now there is some stuff that you need to think about in the camera when you're planning on stacking photos. Primarily, you need to make sure that your camera doesn't move a whole lot. So I actually took another photo that I was planning on stacking to remove some people from, and it didn't work out. So let me show you that. So this photo right here, at first it looks kind of okay, but if I zoom in over here to this grass and such, you can see that it's really just not aligned correctly. And so you have to make sure that your camera doesn't move very much or ideally at all in order for the stacking to work. Affinity Photo does align the images for you if they're slightly off, but it's really easy to get it too far off especially when you're hand holding and you're waiting on people in the scene to move so that you can get a clear shot of what's behind them. It's really easy to just adjust the camera too far for any software really to be able to correct the whole perspective and everything for you. So if you're planning on doing this, I would really recommend putting the camera on a tripod. I didn't have a tripod with me when I shot this photo, which is why I didn't do that. But if I had locked the camera off on a tripod so that it wasn't moving at all, then I would have been able to have gotten several photos across a different period of time and stacked them up and had them all align nicely for me. The other thing you have to watch out for, as we saw with the waves, is other things in the photo moving besides the things that you're trying to eliminate from the photo. And so, you know, if you've got a lot of waves, wind, that sort of thing, you do have to watch out for that as well. Now, again, like I showed you, you can mask off portions of the image. And so that could be a way around that if you want to go through the stack of images. So like on this one, I could probably mask off two out of the three photos from over here. And then my branches and grasses over here will probably start to look okay. But it's not quite as easy as it could be if you just had everything in the frame being still and your camera staying nice and still. So those are the things you need to watch out for when you are shooting photos planning on using the stacking technique. Alright, so that is all for this video. Hopefully that helps you guys if you're editing your photos, trying to remove any people or objects from the photos. That can be really helpful a lot of times to remove some smaller objects, especially with the Inpainting brush in landscape photos, just to help focus the viewer's eye a little bit more and eliminate any kinds of distractions. A lot of times I'll look for kind of shiny things in the frame and things like that and just remove those so that there aren't distracting things throughout the photo. So hopefully that helps you, and if you did enjoy this video, don't forget to hit the like button on your way out and to please subscribe to the channel so that you don't miss more videos that I'm really excited to share with you in the future. As always, thank you so much for watching and I will see you in the next one. As I'm just going to show you how you can remove... Not very good for continuity.